Item number, SCP-284. Object class, safe. Special containment procedures. SCP-284-1 and SCP-284-2 are to be kept under minimal security protocols, with occasional off-site trips when approved by a level 4 or higher personnel. During these trips, they are to be accompanied by a minimum of one level 1 researcher and one level 1 field agent. Their quarters are a standard humanoid containment room with 2 beds. When offered separate containment quarters, they replied that privacy is moot. Description: SCP-284-1 and SCP-284-2 are twins, born on date undisclosed, in Illinois. Though they appear to be normal, they are dizygotic twins who share a single functional brain. SCP-284-1 is female, 1.72 meters tall, containing the left side of the brain. SCP-284-2 is male, 1.79 meters tall, containing the right side of the brain. The portions that are not associated with either lobe are data expunged. In both subjects, the size of the possessed lobe is approximately 50% larger than normal, presumably to allow for maintaining function of two bodies at once. It has been found that while the subjects have separate personalities, they share memories, skills, knowledge, physical sensation, and have shown limited levels of emotional synergy. Though there is no way to know for certain, they claim to have taught themselves how to block out sensory information from each other to varying degrees. Vision and hearing can be blocked out completely, while taste, smell, and touch can be weakened. Doing so is a choice of the one receiving the information, not the one experiencing it. With physical skills, it should be noted that while both subjects have the knowledge of proper technique, muscle tissue only develops to properly execute the skills efficiently, and with significant endurance in the subject who physically learned the skill. While the subjects do not show any advantage in proficiency for skills associated with their respective lobes, it has been found that when separated by a significant distance, they each have delayed responses from the other subject's lobe. Also of note is that both subjects seem incapable of remaining awake more than 16 minutes after the other has fallen asleep, and both awaken at the same time, whether allowed to sleep until they wake up on their own, or woken from their sleep separately. Addendum 284-1. Test Log 284-1. SCP-284-1 and SCP-284-2 were placed at separate ends of the facility. A team of researchers, including 2 surgeons, removed the top of SCP-284-2's cranium and proceeded to apply an electrode to various points on the brain to gauge reactions to the stimuli. In all instances, SCP-284-1 experiences the same sensation or physical reaction as SCP-284-2. Addendum 284-2. Researcher note: today it was noted that while SCP-284-1 was playing the piano in Dr.'s office, SCP-284-2's fingers began twitching erratically. When brought to Dr.'s office, it was discovered that the twitching of SCP-284-2's fingers were in time with the motions of SCP-284-1's fingers as she played. Further study of this phenomenon is being scheduled. Lesson complete. If you missed the previous orientation, go watch SCP-283, A Rock That Falls Sideways, right now. Or for the complete course, watch this playlist.